When the book starts, Chemda is already 80 years old. She's weak, she's bitter, she's sick, and she feels that she didn't love enough, and she was not, she wasn't loved enough, and she feels kind of a failure. But somehow, as the book progresses, she starts feeling that she can still make kind of reconciliation. And this is what she's trying to do throughout all those pages until she dies. And although she's very old, she's still capable of forgiveness and of trying to help her son and her daughter and even her granddaughter. And she finds herself moving in time. I mean, she cannot move physically, but mentally she's moving from being a young child in the kibbutz and a young mother and then throughout all her ages and all her life, and she can experience again all her relationships with her parents and with her children. And I think she manages to give her children before she dies the most beautiful present that a mother can give her children. The main topic of the book is the reconciliation in the family, and it has a lot to do with the ability to love, because you know, love is not enough. Chemda learns it in the most difficult way, because she feels that she loved her son too much and she didn't love her daughter enough. And both her children, well, they're not children anymore, but they both of them feel a bit kind of bitterness, and they blame her for this. So, and they all have to learn a lot about love, and this is what they are trying to do, all three of them. Even an old woman can still learn how to love, and even Avner, who is 40 years old, and his sister, who is a bit older than his, she's longing for the love of the child, and she realizes that she has to learn how to live without the love of the child, if he will not be able to love her. And yes, I try to raise a lot of questions about love. I have more questions than answers, but still I feel that this novel gives some hints about love that even taught me a few things, like the importance of the giving, of the altruistic giving, instead of the endless expectations that we always have. The Bible, the Old Testament, had a huge influence on my life and on my writing. You know, since I was a little child, my father used to read me Bible stories. And I grew up with the feeling that the Bible is open for me, not as a religious text, but as a great literature. And I think it's very important for all of us in Israel, and of course outside of Israel, to be able to read the Bible in an with open eyes and open heart, because the stories are indeed still very relevant. And in all my books, the Bible has a very important part. When they announced the Prix Féminin for this novel, I was so surprised, and I felt so privileged, because, I don't expect prizes, because I believe that writing itself is the prize. And being a writer that has a lot of readers is a huge prize. But then when the Femina came, I really felt so grateful to be awarded in this important historical award. And I still feel it's like a dream, you know.